Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the Angular ComboBox items, header, and footer using templates. I will also show you how to add custom items to the popup list. Let's get right to the code. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion Angular dropdowns package installed. And ComboBox module is configured in the imports array of ng module. In the app component HTML page, I have included the basic ComboBox component rendering code. With this code, you can visualize an employee list. Let's take a quick look at the employee data I have bound to the datasource property of the ComboBox component. You can refer to my Angular ComboBox Getting Started video to learn more about configuring the component. I've shared a link to it in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application and show you the initial output. Look at the combo box. When I click the drop-down icon, the employee list will be displayed. First, I'll show you how to customize the combo box pop-up list items using the template. To define the template content, include the ng template element with the template reference. Then, add the context property letData. Add the wrapper element, and I will include an image tag with the class name employee image and provide the source from Syncfusion demo images. Then I display the employee's name and job with the proper class name. I open the style.css page and define the styles for image, name, and job. Look at the combo box pop-up list now. Image, name, and designation have been added to each list item. I can also customize the pop-up header using the template. I copy and paste this template and change its reference to header template. Then in the template design, I show the header texts, photo, and employee information. I assign the class name header to this element and column header to this. Then I assign the header styles in the style.css page. See here, the ComboBox header has been customized based on the template. I can also set the footer using the template. Here I define the ng template with references footer template and add custom text like add new items. Also, I will show the plus icon with button. I have already installed the Syncfusion Angular Buttons package. In the App Module page, I import Button module and register it into the Imports array of ng module. I add the EJS button tag with CSS class e_small_e_round and icon CSS e-icons plus. Assign the class name footer to this wrapper element. In the style.css page, apply the footer styles same as header. Then I assign the content for plus icon. Check now, the ComboBox pop-up list has a footer based on the provided template. Next, I'll show you how to add custom items to the pop-up list. I add click event in the button and assign the callback method, add new item. I define this method in the app component class. I import the view child from Angular core package and ComboBox component from Angular dropdowns package. To access the ComboBox component, I have already added a reference. Using that reference name, I define the variable combo object of type ComboBox component. Here I declare a variable to get the custom value typed in the ComboBox input element. With that custom value, I create an object with fields, first name, employee ID, and designation. Then append this new item to the data source using the push method. I will close the popup using the hide popup method. I use the add item method to add this custom value to the ComboBox popup list. At last, assign this custom value to the value property of ComboBox so that it will be selected in the popup list. Since I'm inserting the list item dynamically, the image won't be available for that item. In the employee data object, I will add a new field, isImageUploaded, to each item in the list. In app component HTML page, I will change the code to add the image to the template based on this property. Check now, I will type the custom value in the input and click the Add button. Notice, the value is selected in the popup list. Finally, I will show you how to customize the noRecord content using the noRecords template property. Here I remove the properties like DataSource and Fields. Check now, ComboBox popup shows noRecords found. I can display custom message using noRecords template property. I set the custom message, noRecords available. See now, the provided template is displayed when noRecords are found. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to customize the ComboBox list items, header, and footer using templates. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see whether you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.